In this video, what we're going to be covering are project tasks, assignments, and deliverables all in the classroom. So we're gonna do this in a variety of different apps, starting with project planning. This is an app that can be dragged in just like any other app on the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. Let's go ahead and take a look at the overall layout of the app itself. So when you drag it in, on the left side, we can create a new project. We can import a project from a previously existing project. We can see what's new. We can also look to filter only to the projects that you created. And then finally, we can have all of the projects. In this case, we're looking at all of our projects. We only have one. So let's go ahead and create another one. I'll type in caulking gun design team B. So we can create a project from an existing template or a previous project. So we could really just mirror caulking gun design team A if we wanted to, but we're just gonna skip the description for now. And we could also add an image if we wanted to identify our project. So coming in, initially it opens up to this Kanban view where we see all of our tasks, of which there are none right now, but we'll actually get in and create a task from scratch at a later date. Here's our summary, and our summary is where all of the good information is for our milestones tasks and to see if any tasks are at risk. But let's go ahead and take a look at a pre-existing project, this caulking gun design team A, to get a better sense for what this functionality in this app does. So we can see that we have no projects running late or at risk of running late. We have a task burn down. So over the timeline, how many tasks will remain as it currently stands. And of course we have metrics like assignees with open tasks. So as a teacher, this is vital to being able to take a look at your students' assignments to see who's falling behind, who's on track. Coming over to the task tab, we have a bunch of tasks in the to-do column. We can also take a look at the schedule tab and see a nice Gantt chart view of these tasks and the actual burn down of them. So we have milestones, which represent the diamonds. And then just like a regular Gantt chart view, we have all of our tasks. Coming over to the members tab, we can see who is in the project. We can invite people to the project by hitting the plus button. If we want somebody to be able to actually make changes to the actual tasks and add tasks themselves, we need to make sure that their permissions next to their name are a leader permission or an author permission. So now let's go back into our caulking gun design team B and create a task. So to do this, I'm just gonna start typing in the top bar here. The name of our task is initial concept design. We can hit add and open where I can add a description. I can also change the priority state as well. I'll change this to high priority because this is a very important project. I can change the maturity status with the drop down menu to do, in progress, or done. That could be also accomplished by saving this and then dragging it into one of the columns as well. We can take a look at a start and end date. And of course I can add assignees. If they don't come up right away, you just type in their name and they do come up. So it's pretty great. And we can also add an attachment. In this particular case, a project parameters attachment, which is a PDF, to help out our students who are going to be actually creating this project. It's kind of like a syllabus or a rubric. And we can also attach Word documents or any other standard file types that you would think to attach to a deliverable. So now we can actually go ahead and save out this task, and then Gian will be instantly notified that he's been assigned a task. When he opens this up, he's looking with collaborative tasks. Now, collaborative tasks is a little bit different than project planner. Gian will only be able to see the tasks that he's assigned to. While Gian takes a look at the project and drags it into in progress and adds any sort of attachments or deliverables, let's go ahead and take a look at how we create a project milestone. So I can hit the plus side, create new milestone. Obviously we can add a name to this milestone, nothing new here. And I'm gonna change the date for this new milestone to be the same date as the task ends. Click create. And then what I can do is actually just drag and drop a line between the two. So that way our initial design review is fixed on the initial concept design. So now we can see that Gian has dragged the caulking gun task, the initial concept design, into done. So what I can do in this case is open this up, and with the 3D Play app, I can just simply drag and drop his deliverable into this 3D Play app to view it and take a look at what he's got for me. So right off the bat, I think this looks a little bit familiar, if I'm being honest. I think I've seen this one before. So what I can do in this particular case, because I know it's not quite done yet, I can jump back into Project Planner. And I can write him a comment saying, this looks familiar. And when I do this, I'm gonna drag this back to in progress because again, I don't think he's done with the task that I gave him because quite frankly, I think he cheated. And while he ponders and looks over the comment that I made for him, let's go ahead and do some investigative research ourselves with collaborative lifecycle. So I'm gonna go back into his deliverable and I'm just going to drag the caulking gun into collaborative lifecycle so I can take a look at who actually owns this project. Now down here we see we have the blue dot, which represents the original project, and the orange dot represents a revision or a save as version of the project. So Gian is the owner of the save as version, as we can see down below. But if I look at the original version, which is the blue dot, and go into the properties, we see that I'm in fact the owner of that model. So in this case, we were able to catch Gian's dishonesty. He replied to a comment too, and we could take a look at that, see what sort of sorry excuse he has for submitting somebody else's model. And he says, you must be pretty familiar with amazing caulking guns. Yes, I am very familiar. So in this video, what we did was take a look at project tasks, deliverables and assignments in the classroom, how to organize these projects, how to assign tasks to students and yourself as well. And we also got to the bottom of a little cheating scandal by taking a look at collaborative lifecycle and seeing who actually owns the model that was submitted. So that's it for this video.